I return with a very sore throat, and still the same horrible setup. But what did you expect? The only thing that's changed since the last video was recorded or uploaded is the fact that I am now a year older. I almost went to state and extent. I went to all school dances, and, well, my hair isn't pink, and it's a little shorter. But other than that, still the same piece of shit that there was back then. But, at the very least, I'm not a piece of shit who's going to be talking about video games again. I actually do have more of taste than just video games. Surprise. Anyway, so, I have some series that I'm probably going to be doing if I continue to do YouTube videos, which remains to be seen. There will be Game Talk, which of course is video games, or just really games in general. So, cinema, which will be film and television. Bookish, which will be about pretty much any form of literature. Nostalgia Hour, which will be childhood stuff and things that make me nostalgic. And then Rambling Rants, which you are seeing the first installment of, which is about rants. Duh. And I figured I would start it off not with my Bethesda rant, because that'll probably get very heated about. But instead, The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer. A book that apparently has two sequels that I hate. Now, first off, The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer is part of a trilogy called the Mara Dyer Trilogy, and it is by a woman named Michelle Hodkin. And you know what really saddens me about this entire thing is the fact that Michelle Hodkin is not necessarily that bad of a writer. She's not that bad at description of, like, what's going on. Her grammar isn't horrendous, her spelling isn't bad, but then again, it could be, and her editor may have fixed it all. But most everything else, characters, plot, setting, anything, everything else is pretty bad. The three books in the series are very boringly named as well. They are The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer, the only one that I read and I hated, The Evolution of Mara Dyer, and The Retribution of Mara Dyer. I hope y'all ignored the Discord notification I got. So, clearly, my opinion on this is not positive, and I would say that I hate this book, and I hate this series, solely based on how I felt about the book, the first one. And there's plenty of reasons why, and don't worry, I will not spare you from it. First off, on my little handy-dandy outline here, Mara Dyer has no personality, and is in fact a very poorly written main character. And if the rest of the characters were much better, I might be able to excuse it, because there are actually, like, series that take bland, boring main characters, but make it work because the rest of the characters have the personality the protagonist lacks. However, that doesn't really happen. And in fact, I just realized this. I don't think The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer actually has an antagonist. You can't even say it's self versus self, because not. There's nothing going on in this book. Reason number one for Mara's shitty character design, development, whatever you want to say, is of course the fact that she has no personality. And a lot of that just comes from the fact that she's really, really boring. Like, she doesn't give anything. She doesn't give emotion or feeling or anything. She just kind of exists and reacts to things. and, like, never states her opinion on things except the slutty girl, Noah, and her best friend. Oh, and then the people from her past, but pretty much everyone she interacts with is poorly written, so doesn't really matter. And now, to, go into the only time you see anything from her other than her interactions with others. She's very internally sexist. It's not necessarily something that you notice right away, or you notice in general. It's not blatant, but it's there, and it's not that difficult to pick up on. And the biggest reason I say this is the fact that she literally believes she's superior because she doesn't sleep around. You literally started dating your best friend's brother behind her back. And I mean, it's not the same thing. Who fucking cares? You're still not superior. You're still a piece of shit. If you wanna, like, put it into those fucking stupid slut-shaming terms. Just saying. But the largest reason I actually say this is the fact that Mara is submissive to men, not because she just doesn't want to be confrontational and she's just a naturally submissive person, because she can be fucking aggressive. She may not have personality, but she can sure as hell be aggressive. It's only to men that she is submissive. And again, it's not like a choice, it's she just does not stand up for herself when it comes to men. She does to anyone else. She does when it is Anna, the slutty girl that's for some reason her fucking enemy. She does to her parents, I'm pretty sure. But Noah? Jude? No. The dude who, like, kidnapped her fucking brother or some bullshit? No. Nobody! And it's ridiculous, and I don't understand. I mean, Mara just also has shitty taste in boys, but that's also probably just a personal opinion. But last but not least, she's fucking overpowered. Like, holy shit. And, you know, I might be able to accept it if there was a fucking purpose to her having that power, but there isn't. And if there, or maybe there is, but it's not introduced until the next book, or maybe even the last one, and that's just poor writing. You're gonna introduce a superpower, you have to introduce the purpose for them having that superpower, or it looks bad. Just in general. And that's not done here. But Mara is not the only horrible character, everybody is. Her abusive British bad boy boyfriend, who thinks he's culturally superior because he's British. If the British had a fucking culture other than tea, crumpets, xenophobia, and fucking imperialism, maybe I'd believe you. But they don't. Sorry, Noah. The stereotypical slutty girl who for some reason is Mara's enemy when they didn't know each other at all. The bitch literally hates Mara because Noah showed her attention. I mean, I can get Noah's attention by calling him a piece of fucking shit. You gonna be jealous then? Who knows? The annoying, stereotypical kid brother. The borderline negligent parents. The consistently cranky and hate-filled Latin or Spanish teacher or whatever. So, you go to a fucking public school in Florida, they probably don't have Latin. Just saying. But last but not least, the fact that Mara's fucking best friend, after she moves, is the most token of token characters. He is black, Jewish, and bisexual, and you know what? That wouldn't be a problem if it wasn't for the fact that he was the only one out of the main cast who was not white, straight, cis, and atheistic, agnostic, or Christian. So, he's literally token as fuck. And then, if you look back to her two best friends and boyfriend before she moved, one of them she ended up starting to hate because she thought she was taking away her best friend. Well, here's the thing, if you think your best friend is leaving you for somebody else, they're not your best friend. And then her shitty fucking boyfriend, who she seems scared of. Honestly. Oh, and I'm pretty sure also tried to fucking sexually assault her at one point. Like, literally, everybody's just horrible. And I wouldn't say that they were horrible if there was a purpose to them, maybe, but there isn't. There's no purpose. They just exist. But, you know what? A main cast of characters like that can only work in a plot that doesn't know the fuck it is, or what it wants. And that is exactly what the unbecoming of Mara Dyer does. The first fourth to half of the book has no plot, what's like actual overarching plotline whatsoever, other than she got amnesia from this weird fucking accident, moved, and is going to this new school where she meets these people. And then 180 degree fucking turn, and it's suddenly supernatural. She has this power where she can literally kill people just by thinking about their death. Noah apparently has some power. Her brother gets kidnapped. There's no, like, explanation as to why that happens. I'm pretty sure it never said anything about mystery or powers being tied to something larger. It just happens. It's there. That's all. And I don't understand. And I don't know, it doesn't know what genre it wants to be. And you don't have to stick to one genre with what you write. I know this myself. I'm writing something that is realistic / general fiction and romance. But you see, it's easy to understand. It's this queer kid going to community college where he meets this guy who becomes friends with, who he thinks is just an ally, who he finds out after asking him essentially, "Why the hell are you so intent on protecting me?" Well, he pretty much says that he cares about him, that because of it he fell in love with him. And it's easy to understand. It's literally just college kids. It's a college romance. That's easy to understand. But The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer is not easy to understand. It's not realistic fiction entirely. It's not paranormal fiction entirely. It's not romance entirely. It's not mystery, thriller. It's nothing. You can't pinpoint anything because it's such a conglomeration that was done poorly. And it's not just the plot. In general, it's difficult to tell what Hodkin wanted with it. It's difficult to tell what the plot wanted. I can't tell you what it wanted at all. And that makes me wonder, like, did Hodkin have an editor past grammar and spelling? Because editors should not be letting things that are impossible to pinpoint and all over the place without reason pass through their fingers and get published. Like, I can literally tell you a decent chunk of like non-published fiction that deserves more, like, actual recognition and publishing than The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer does. Not even because what the plot is about, but the fact that it could not decide what it wanted to be. There are hundreds and maybe thousands even of books on Wattpad, on Quotium, on Tumblr, on the fucking internet, anywhere, that are so much more deserving of that publication, not even because what the plot was, but because it knew what it wanted, it communicated that, and it did it well. And I think that, out of everything, is what bothers me. When I finished the book, and I only finished it because I had to, I felt confused and not in the good way. I wanted to know why it couldn't stick to one type of fucking conflict. If it even had a conflict at all, I didn't understand. And the unbecoming of Mara Dyer was such a horrible experience for me that I think I finished reading it when I was 14. It was near the end of 8th grade. Only about 3 years ago. And at least for 2 of those years, I did not want to read anything with a female main character because I did not want to go through that again. And I know you can have that with any, like, main character. There are plenty of books with really shitty fucking male main characters, but Mara Dyer killed it for me entirely, and it also made me very wary of anything that had any kind of romantic implication, which is odd because I literally write stuff with at least implied romance in it all the time. Even if one-sided, maybe, or requited, I don't know. But I do, and it's really odd that I can't read stuff like that without approaching it with caution. And it's all because of Mara Dyer. It is not any other book. It is solely the unbecoming of Mara Dyer. And I mean, I guess all of this is personal opinion, but everything is boiled down to personal opinion when you really think about it. And what's really saddening is the market for books like that is fucking giant. And if it isn't giant, it's at the very least loud and constantly demanding more content. So we're always going to see more things like that getting published, rather than things that are much more deserving. Things that are much more coherent. Things that are much more well planned out. I don't know. I had to re-record this, by the way. It was very missed for me. Maybe it's a hit for some people. I know it's a hit. It's literally got a 4.1 fucking rating on Goodreads, and I don't understand how that happened. That book shouldn't have more than a 3. You know, there are books that have lower rankings that are 10,000 times better. Prime example is Toni Morrison's Beloved. And you know what? I know Beloved is difficult to understand. But the purpose of that difficult to understand factor works. And if you actually fucking understand it, like myself, you appreciate it. The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer shouldn't be higher than 3.0. But it is. And that just goes to show, really, how little talent you need in telling a story. How you can piece together cliches and half-thought-out ideas. But if you have that right thing inside of it, everybody will fucking praise it. And, you know, it might seem like I don't know what I'm talking about. Because, I mean, I am 17. But here's the thing. I've been writing all my life. Duh. Went to an American public school. But I've been writing seriously for 4 years, and in 4 years I have seen more development as a writer than I think most people have in 10 years' time. Not just in fiction, but in essays, in any kind of writing, I have gotten so much better in 4 years than most people do in twice that. And I'm going into English. I am actually planning on going to University of Iowa, getting into their writing program, which is incredibly fucking exclusive, and majoring in English and creative writing. And I'm going into the editing and publishing business, and I definitely won't be starting out in HarperCollins or anything like that, but that's where I aim to go, is one of those big name publishing companies, and I aim to clean up what the fuck gets through publishers. I aim to clean out the shitty things. The things like that new book by Veronica Roth, which is literally just fucking racial coding. Not even hidden, it's blatant. Blatant racial coding that's meant to be racist. You know, I aim to have a bit of an impact as an editor alone. I also aim to be published and to show what kind of content should be out there. And you know what, that probably sounds a little stuck up, but I'm a fucking writer. We're all pretentious. I just don't understand. And I probably never will. My vocal cords really hurt. And I should probably just end this. Thank you for listening to this rant. It was much more of a rant than the first one I recorded. I don't remember my old intro, but stay cool, my dudes. And if you can't find peace in your life, make it. I mean, that'll be a little difficult considering the shape of the world right now, but as long as you try, who knows how it'll turn out. So, thanks, guys. Peace, yo.